Hey everybody, welcome back to One Piece, Kaizoku Musou, the Let's Play variation of such. Alright, so as I mentioned last part, and in case you missed last part, I guess somehow, the last half of this game is not going to be blind anymore because I recorded it originally and the footage all got corrupt. So, that's a bit of a shame, but maybe I can make the commentary more interesting this time around. So, back into the main log. Alright, last time we tackled the many people who are trying to block our way to Robin. And this time we're gonna fight the boss gauntlet stage. It's pretty fun. So it's the Pirates versus CP9. I wish it was like all the CP9 fights or something, but we only get a few. But oh well, moving on, let's start it up. This Straw Hats infiltrate Eni's lobby, breaking through a 10,000 strong force of Marines before reaching the Tower of Judgment where Robin is held. Just to let you guys know, I'm drinking like double the amount of rum and coke, because I've already recorded this and I need to get through this somehow, so. But Spandam, the leader of CP9, has already taken Robin elsewhere to the pair is heading for the gate. It's the Judgment. If they successfully cross through it, it'll be near impossible to rescue Robin from the prison beyond. The Straw Hats split up to take on CP9 in order to find the key to the Sea Prism stone handcuffs on Robin, and to catch up with Spandam as quickly as possible. Soga King takes on CP9 member Jabra, only to be caught by a sneak attack and injured. The outlook seems bleak for winning this battle. Poor Soga King. He just can't do it, man. It's impossible. It's not gonna work out.
バカ!てめえも次に死ぬんだよ!さあ、死ね!
Little shepherd boy hunting down the wolf, as it were. We're playing a Sanji against this fight. It's pretty fun that we get the switch between the Straw Hats in this chapter to do the individual fights against CP9. It's pretty cool. He was special in this wolf, man. Jabra and another character who we'll see in a second are an interesting pair. Look at him do his little wolf dash around here. Doing his little wolf dash. I'm in the air still. Oh boy. This hurts a lot, actually. This is hurting my soul, my face with his claws, man. It hurts. And this ought to finish him off. Devil loves spices. And now we're switching over to Zoro for his perspective on things. Things are a little bit wrong here because Usopp was actually with Zoro in the anime. And there's a whole other CP9 member that Sanji faced off against that we don't even see here. Kaku has appeared. We don't even see him at all.
Oh,
丈夫な男じゃ。呆れたもんじゃわい。
鍛えてあんだよ、キリンじゃ。
キリンじゃ？わしはキリンじゃ。わしをバカにしとるとただじゃすまんぞ。
高えとこから物言いやがって、てめえ自分が倒れる姿すら想像もしてねえタイプだな。頭が高え。
貴様もじゃ。
Oh, so we're both going down? I've heard enough. Giraffes are awesome. I love giraffes. So, Kaku here and Jabiru, but I already forgot his name. I've been drinking too much alcohol. They had this cool little dynamic in the anime. They were arguing, like, what's better, wolves or giraffes. It was hilarious. But what I was talking about earlier, Sanji faces off against another CP9 member. He's a female, so he's all being stupid because he's an idiot, and I hate his character but in any way, shape, or form. And he almost gets killed. And yeah. Just laying to Kaku as hard as possible. But we don't really talk about the CP9 members before we figure out the CP9 members in this game at all. Because they seem so cool and awesome in the anime. Like, they seem like really chill people, and they're like, they're all part of the Galley Law, and they're all building ships and stuff, and they have great personalities. What the hell's that animation? And they just turn into big jerks, because they're actually a bunch of butts working for the world government. Now, Kaku didn't have a power originally. Him and the female member we don't see in this game didn't have these powers, but they eat them before the Straw Hats get it.
ならば最強の乱客、アマネたちで、お前を真っ二つにしてしまいじゃ。
苦難上等、好む者なり修羅の道、わしら一流銀。どっちか、あいつに手こずってんのか。手貸すか。
いや、俺があいつを止めるから、先に行け。ロビンが待ってる。
そうはさせんと言ったはず。
すごい、てめえも能力者だったのか。
まずお前を消そう、フランキー。忘れたか、麦わらのルフィ。ガレーラの屋敷でこの姿の俺にひとつきにされたことを。
あれ、肉食ったら治った。頼むの、ジェットバズーカ。
So the cool thing about this chapter is, like, to overcome the CP9, all the Straw Hats are showing off their newer abilities, and it is just great. Ow. Okay, I gotta be careful here. This guy does a lot of damage if I'm not really aware of my fighting, so this is gonna be a little bit awkward. Oh, I was trying to dodge and I couldn't. I stuck my hip pose animation. Gamugamu no!
Mone no aru tatakai ga shitai nara, misete yaru yo. Mou hitotsu no senpō. Ya! Sado! Mone fuusen! Hiro! Kono ude wa kyojinzoku no ude! Gamugamu no!
Okay, time to book it. Time to book it. I can't fight like this. This is the huge downside to Gear 3rd, is that early on, Luffy doesn't know how to really control it properly, and he has this disadvantage of shrinking. And all these little guys are running around trying to distract me from my main fight here. He's a bunch of jerks. He's a bunch of chumps. Ow. You know what, let's just blow him away. Here, I go another way. I gotta fight Lucci here. I gotta fight Pigeon Guy. Yeah, this whole arc is basically about everybody showing off their new skills that they kind of learned off screen. We don't discuss how they really figure them out or how they get into them, but they show them off here. They show off all these neat abilities. I don't know if they covered it better in the manga, but I remember the anime too. They're just like, oh, I have this new power I can do. And it was like, oh. So, whatever. I'll... This guy's jumping around like the rest of the CP9 members try to do, because they think they're all that in the big chips. I'm getting pretty lucky with this guy getting stuck here. I'm getting pretty lucky about this. This ought to finish him off. Alright, right into Gear 2nd, we're gonna continue the fight. Let's blow this bastard away. Except this is the part of the fight where he starts being a big old Tom Pussycat. And avoiding us as much as possible. It's a little bit annoying and a bit disappointing, but you know what, whatever. We haven't hit the gimmick of this fight quite yet, but I really wish this wasn't such a gimmick fight, I really do. Because he just hangs back here, and then... so stupid. I wish this wasn't such a gimmick fight. This could have been such an awesome one-on-one, but nope. A little bit disappointing, but you know what? Whatever. I'm not a game designer, so I don't know. Maybe they thought to break out the gameplay or something, because everybody else... Like, the two other fights we just did were straight-on fights up until now, so...
Look
at how much health that takes off, but... Try to do a little bit of damage on him before he just runs away again. Nope, he just ran away immediately. Never mind. Never mind. Ow. Oh, well, I missed that. Okay, well, we gotta stand here for an extra 12 minutes. So wait for this stupid thing to recharge. Alright. Back on over and just destroy all these people just waiting on the ship, because, you know, we just have to kill so many innocents. Just have to kill so many people for the hell of it. There's one guy. Oh, no, there's two people living. Get over here. And we enter the same cutscene, which is. This is why I'm disappointed in this fight, because we don't really get to fight him in this last phase in Gear 2nd. We just do this in cutscenes. Not even cutscene, QTE. It's just not as satisfying as I'd like it to be, is all. So let me just get this out of my system now. This scene, this is the scene in the anime that just convinced me. I saw this clip on YouTube and it just convinced me that I absolutely had to watch One Piece. So I'm gonna beg you guys right now, stop ruining the experience. If you haven't seen One Piece yet, stop right now. Don't watch any more of this game. Go watch One Piece. This scene in this game, just not even close to do this scene justice. It's just so much better to experience the show. I implore you, stop right now, go watch the show. It is worth every hour you put into it.
とんでもねえ奴らだ。世界政府相手に本当に何もかも奪い返してきやがった。
うわあ、おい、なんだ、どうしたんだ急に。
急にも何も、これが当然なんじゃねえのか。メリーはもう二度と走れねえと断定されてた船だ。忘れたわけじゃねえだろ。
おっさん、 やべえ、メリーがやべえよ、なんとかしてくれ。ずっと一緒に旅してきた仲間なんだよ。さっきもこいつに救われたばっかりだ。
だったらもう眠らせてやれ。俺は今奇跡を見てる。もう限界なんか遠に超えてる船の奇跡を。長年船大工をやってるが、俺はこんなにすごい海賊船を見たことがない。見事な生き様だった。
わかった。じゃあいいか、みんな。メリー、海底は暗くて寂しいからな。俺たちが見届ける。ウソップはいなくてよかったかもな。あいつがこんなの耐えられるわけがねえ。
どう思う？
そんなことないさ。決別の時は来る。男の別れだ。涙の一つもあってはいけない。彼にも覚悟はできてる。
長い間俺たちを乗せてくれてありがとう、メリー号。
冒険したかった。だけど僕は。
ごめんするなら俺たちの方だぞ、メリー。俺家事下手だからよ。お前を氷山にぶつけたりよ。本も破ったことあるしよ。ゾロもサンジもアホだからいろんなもん壊すしよ。そのたんびウソップが直すんだけど下手くそでよ。ごめんスーなら。
だけど僕は幸せだった。今まで大切にしてくれてどうもありがとう。僕は本当に幸せだった。
Goodbye, Mary. Goodbye.
メリー号に別れを告げた麦わらの一味はウォーターセブンに身を潜めた。その地で伝説の船大工の弟子フランキーの手により麦わらの一味の新しい船が完成。港に堂々たる姿を現した。
さあ乗れよフランキー、俺の船に。
へえ、生意気言うんじゃねえよ。ハリボテ修理しかできねえどうしろ。ともめ、
We're not gonna mention the ball crushing scene. No, not gonna talk about that at all. No, no, we're not.
出航の日より遡ること数日前、麦わらの一味は未だ帰ってこないウソップについて話し合っていた。船長が威厳を失った一味は必ず崩壊する。 一味を抜けたけじめをつけない限りウソップを許すことはできない。そんなゾロの言葉に他の者たちはウソップを迎えに行きたい気持ちをこらえるしかなかった。
ウソップの最初の一声が深い謝罪であればよし、それ以外ならもう奴に帰る場所はない。
そうだな、出航までまだ何日もある。黙ってあいつを待とう。
しかしウソップが現れないまま日は経ち、海軍に追われるようにして麦わらの一味は出航を決めた。
どういうことだ、なんで船が出てんだよ。
待てよお前ら、俺様がまだここにいるじゃねえか。おい喜べ、俺だぞ。
ウソップが来たぞルフィ、ウソップが来た。
なおい、なんとか言えよ。いい加減にしろお前ら。
ウソップが呼んでるよ。
聞こえねえ。
何も聞こえねえな。
なんだよ、本当に俺と別れようってんだな。そうかい、そっちがその気なら最後に一つ言わせてもらうぞ。
ごめん、意地張ってごめん、今さらみっともねえんだけども、俺一味をやめるって言ったけど、あれ取り消すわけにはいかねえかな。ダメかな。頼むからよ、お前らと一緒にいさせてくれ。もう一度俺を仲間に入れてくれ。ルフィ、
バカ野郎、早く捕まれ。
バカはおめえだ。
かっこ悪いわね、あんたたち。
やっと全員揃った。さあ冒険に行くぞ野郎ども。
パケットのコイン、それと You wanna be my friend。We are on a cruise. We are. And with that, the straw has band back together. And we continue on our sails for the new world. So we don't get there quite yet. We got a hell of a lot more in front of us. It just gets more intense from here.So, once again, I beg you guys to watch the anime. I really do. Just do it. Just do yourselves a favor. Honestly, just go do it. With all that said and done, though, this has been Bluebomberimo. I am drunk. So, the next episode ought to be fun. So, until then, have a great day.Look at me drinking at 10 a.m.